increases for solo clarinet without piano accompaniment. These are two little monologues. Meditations for solo clarinet. While much of Sumera's music is based on the principles of simplicity and improvisation, it's definitely not lacking display and technical virtuosity, as you are about to hear. Please welcome our clarinet soloist, Joanna Hauser, who will play the two capriccios for solo clarinet by Lepo Sumera. For our next work, we return to the music of Arvo Pärt. This time we're going to hear his Hymn to a Great City for two pianos. Personally, I think the piece should be called Hymn to the Great Tri-Cities. I don't think he was ever here. It's possible. He did make it as far as Winnipeg. Yes, okay. It's also based on simplicity. It uses no minor chords. For this work, please welcome our dueling pianist, Jane Hayes, and Anna Levy for Arvo Pärt's Hymn to a Great City. Thank you. national anthem. That should be it. Okay. Now, I hope I got this right. If I don't, I'll certainly hear about it. For our next work, I'd like to welcome back our clarinet soloist, Johanna Hauser, for Senza Metro per Clarinetto in A, for clarinet and piano forte. This was a piece was composed as a required piece for clarinet players at the All-Estonian Competition for Young Performers of Wind and Percussion Instruments in 1986, and it had its premiere on November 24th of that year in Tallinn. So please welcome back our two soloists. This time, Johanna will be joined by Anna Levy on piano.
Too comfortable. I wonder if you could put the piano down halfway.
Oh. I get my fingers stuck in the piano. Well,
soon. No.
I will. Okay.
Hey, it's your piano.
We don't want to go in out of the room. Thank you.
our next work, again, I better have it right.
Yes.
It's called Silent Odalisque. And together with singing odalisque and sorrowful odalisque belongs to a cycle of odalisques for various instruments. These date from 1997. So, what is an odalisque? Well, apparently, it was a female slave in an Ottoman seraglio. And she was an assistant or an apprentice to the concubines and wives. I know they were immortalized in a series of paintings by a French 19th century painter who did reclining odalisques. Anyways, please welcome our flute soloist, this is for solo flute, back to our stage, Catherine Chinaskas, for Silent Odalisque. Thank you. work welcomes back our two pianists in a work called One Without Two. It is perhaps the sequel of Two Without One, anyway. It was a work premiered in Finland in 1993. In it, Sumera continues to cultivate his interest in unmeasured and improvised music within traditional confines. This is a fun piece. And please welcome our two dueling pianists, Jane Hayes and Anna Levy, for One Without Two. Thank you. We're going to conclude today's tribute to Lepo Sumera with his music from 1981. This is an intense and riveting composition for solo piano that has been performed more than 2,000 times worldwide. It was one of the themes for the CBC's now defunct contemporary music program, Two New Hours. And it is probably his most famous piano piece. And while based on principles of simplicity, it is a veritable tour de force. So please welcome, this is for solo piano, please welcome Anna Levy for Sumera's music for 1981.